for you guys today. And it's going to be topped off with, we're going to be crowning a world champion. We're going to see a world champion around about 7 o'clock tonight, head to head.
A new world champion.
No guessing, he's the Dutchman. Dutchman in the corner.
Let's go, Lewis! Well,
he's on pole position. He's definitely going to be controlling the race. But anything can happen around this circuit. If you watch Jeddah a week ago, that might give you a little bit of an insight as to what can happen here at the Yas circuit. Very, very tight, very, very fast, difficult to overtake. So I think if Lewis sees a gap, he will go for it. We know that Max will not give him an inch. But I think both drivers have been told to behave. There is the potential that should there be a deliberate accident on track, that one will be deducted points. So I think we're in for a fantastic race this afternoon, there's no doubt. However, we have got Lando sitting in third place, Daniel in 10th. So Lando is in a grandstand seat. He's in absolutely the perfect position to pick up any pieces should Max and Lewis decide to kiss on the track. So a great afternoon in store. But what we thought we'd do to start off. Okay, good afternoon again, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry to interrupt you once again, but it is for very, very good reason. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd love you to put your hands together for Chris Mazzetta, CEO of Hilton. Daniel Ricciardo, McLaren F1 driver, all right, ladies and gentlemen, good time. And Zach Brown, Zach, CEO of McLaren Racing. Gents, thank you very much for joining us. Take a seat if you'd like, gents. Thank you very much for coming to join us just before the race, especially Daniel. You've got a bit of a busy afternoon this afternoon. I'd like to start off with you.
Fisher and Dan McEwen as well. We are all here all day to enhance your Formula One experience here in the McLaren Suite. And joining me to my right, Mr. John Satori, our resident bespoke Formula One analyst and commentator. John Satori,
how old are you? This is going to be a belter of a day.
I think so. History.
You get it? Nice.
We were on the same flight. We were on the flight. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
they take the paint right off. So the drivers need to be able to see the curves on the exit, and I think you're going to see a lot of drivers running wide, especially on the race track. Yeah, on the race track, this is going to be key. I think some guys in the front will use the one that they have to move somebody like beside them to avoid crashing. You know, we saw all of those times, the three race starts in Saudi, now they're fighting for the championship. Max is in the front, Lewis is in second. It's going to be a very, very tough start.
What's your prediction?
So, that's a very good question. Maybe Checo needs a braking. He has Lewis in front. I don't know. Let's see what happens.
So, yesterday we've seen a lot of hell all the way down to the junior ranks in Finland. And it was a big learning curve for me, learning how to drive in a draft. We're starting to see in go-karts even, a lot of aerodynamics on these go-karts, making it so karts have air wash, which is absolutely ridiculous in my opinion. But it takes a lot of time to get to know, to get to learn that, and you see a lot of drivers struggle with it, especially in Formula 2 here.
Yeah, for sure. It's very tricky to drive behind another car. And this is a tricky section. You can see some yellows, orange sausage curve over here. That's to stop the drivers from cutting the track. But we saw on the Formula 2, they were running wide, some of them, when they are side by side on the braking point. We might see the same things. And the marshals, they are so positive, so excited to see he's fighting for the championship.
A safety car, especially in this corner. I'm not entirely sure if it's going to be in the first or second sector, but this corner has been a problem for very many drivers this weekend. You see Valtteri Bottas going to the wall there, you've seen Kimi Raikkonen going to the wall. Kimi went in a bit harder than Bottas did, but Bottas just tapped it on the exit, and you've seen that last weekend in Jeddah with Max. I'm surprised he actually didn't have any damage from that.
Yeah, it's amazing. Maybe there was a small suspension damage, but the gearbox was completely fine. Hopefully, the cars run clean and we have a fight for the championship until the end of the race, as we have in Jeddah, fighting side by side, as we see everybody so excited for this end of the season, as we're heading to the last corner of this amazing race circuit. As I told you at the beginning, it's a very unique place to be, very unique here in Abu Dhabi, last race of the season. As we see the pit entry on the right, the main straight on the left, prepare your cameras because this is the most iconic view of the racetrack, with the Royal Tower just on the back, the grandstands on the left, Paddock Club on the right, beautiful scenery.
Also guys, in that last apex there,
That bollard on the apex is brand new. Do you know why? It's because everybody comes through and smacks it every time, and it ends up on the race.
Schumacher did it. I think Matt, Lawrence hit it with the car. You can see the downforce of the car because it's sucking under the car.
Amazing.
Yuki hit it, Norris hit it, Schumacher hit it, and a ton of two guys hit it.
So everybody loves that apex curve because they're trying to get a monster run down the straightaway into this DRS zone. But I just hope that
our Formula One experience. As promised, we're going to have a nice chat now with Formula One driver Lando Norris. Give him a big cheer. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm excited.
Good.
Final racing season, so I'm looking
forward to it. Wow, what a lap yesterday. That was just incredible. P3. Did you feel you had that P3 lap, did you?
No.
No?
I mean, of course, I thought I had the lap within me. Whether or not I would have been third or fifth or sixth is the question. So, of course, I wasn't expecting to be third. Because to be ahead of a Mercedes and to be ahead of a Red Bull is, not something we usually do, and they're much quicker cars than us, so a pretty big achievement.
Thank you.